हेलो हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। लेसन 10 क्लास 6 मोर अबाउट इंटरनेट। और नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज यूजेस ऑफ इंटरनेट। वी नॉर्मली सी द कैप्शंस लाइक विजिट अस ऑन www.yahoo.com, www.greenearthpublications.com एंड सो ऑन लाइक दैट। सच टाइप ऑफ टेक्स्ट दैट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम www एंड एंड्स विथ .in, .com, .org एक्सेट्रा is known as web addresses. It is also called as URL. We need to type URL in the address bar of Internet Explorer to view any website. That means to visit any website, we need to type this URL. Suppose you want to visit Facebook, we will write www.facebook.com. Next one, various uses of Internet are like searching information, downloading and uploading data, and many services such as railway reservation, online banking, hotel reservation, airline reservation, bus reservation, etc. Next one is advantages of email. One of the primary advantages of email is speed, which electronic message can literally travel at the speed of light. A traditional post letter may take days or even week to reach its destination. Email is an extremely inexpensive system compared to normal post office. Once a computer has been connected to the internet, there is virtually no cost needed to send electronic message. That means after by using the email we will send very extremely fast. Suppose I am in Hyderabad, you are in Kashmir. If you need any certificate or computer based on the computer certificate, I will send within seconds, which is not possible by the normal post. Normal post, it will take to basically 3 to 4 working days. So by using this email, we can send our message very instantly, very fast. It will not waste our time. Next one is limitations of email. Everyone does not have an email addresses, so you can only send to the people who have email ID. That means if everyone is not having the email address, then you can't send the email. But the persons who are having the email address only, you can send the emails. Second is the hardware requirement and internet connection is required to send and receive the email. That means you required hardware equipment. That means you required system, laptop or PC, any kind of, and one internet connection also required to send the or receive the mails. Next one, search engine. A search engine is a computer program to get the desired information on the World Wide Web, that means www. The search results are usually presented in a list. You need to select the, click it according to your requirement. Most popular search engine is google.com. Steps to find the information from the Google search engine. Open web browser, that means open any Google Chrome or Mozilla Fox or Internet Explorer. Then type www.google.com in address bar and press enter key. The Google homepage appears. Type ICC Champions Trophy 2013 in search bar and click the Google search. A list of web pages will be displayed. Click any of the links to display the web page. You can also copy the text and images from the web pages. Copy text and images from the web page. To copy the text from the web pages, we need to follow the given step. Select the text by dragging the mouse. Right-click the mouse and select copy from the list. Open the document where you want to paste it. Then right-click this and select paste option. The text is pasted in the document. If you want to get the images from the web, then follow the given steps. Open the Google site, search for the images and click on the images option. Type the name of the image and click on the search, press enter. Number of images will be appear. Select the desired image and the image appears in the big view. Right click on that and click on save link as or save as window appears. Type name and direct, select the desired location of the image, click save. The image will be saved in your computer at desired location. Let us have a look at a small video how to open web browser and how to search the data, how to copy the data and how to copy the images from the web page. First, we will open the web browser. I am opening the Google Chrome. See, web browser is opened. Now, see here, we need to type www.google.com. Then Google search engine will appear. Now, I will write here ICC Champions Trophy. I am writing here and it will displace the, see here, these many links, and now I'll click one link to open the, see, I opened this one, see, we'll get the ICICI, about the ICICI Champions Trophy details. Now same with the case, now I want to copy the data. Now I'll open about, see here, now what is Champions Trophy. Now I will first select the data by left click and drag it and hold and leave the mouse pointer, and right click and click on copy, and open any document file. So I am opening here Notepad, see here, Notepad is open, and right click and click on paste. See, the data is copied from there to here. In this way we can copy the data. Next one is how to save the image. I am writing here, suppose Apple. Now I'll click on images, fruit. See, now I like this image, so image will be opened in big view. Then right click on that one, save image as, and dialog box appears, select the location and write here Apple, desired name of the file and location I am saving in the desktop, click on save and close this one, and see here it is there, Apple. See, in this way we can save the image from the web and save the, copy the data from the web, and we can search the data in the Google Chrome. Here write google.com and write here anything about, I'm writing here about banana. See here, search engine is searching for the data. In this way we can search the data in Google. Next one is points to remember while using internet services. Features to be keep in mind while using the internet services. That means we need to remember some points while using the internet. First point is keep your computer updated. That means it is essential to use antivirus software and keep it up to date. That means we need to always keep it up to date, the antivirus software. Next one is create strong and secure password. That means the password must contain at least 8 characters with the combination of letters and numbers and symbols. Do not share your passwords with anyone. Next one is download file legally. Downloading music, movies and other files from unreliable website can harmful to your computer. That means your system may get viruses if you downloaded that pirated music or pirated movies. Next one is do not give out personal information such as addresses, telephone numbers, parents' work address and numbers via email, chats, websites or social networking platform. That means in these places like Facebook, Twitter and chats, email, you should not give your personal information. Now next one is scan all attachments. There are sent to your protect to your system from the viruses. That means we need to scan each and every document or attachment which we have downloaded from the internet. That means it will protect us from the viruses. Avoid surfing unreliable sites. That means never click any pop-up windows that comes in advertisements which you open some sites. They may contain malware. That means if you open any sites, some pop-ups will come. Click here to purchase goggles for 99 rupees. Click here to purchase watch for 99 rupees. If you click that one, the site may contain malware. That means virus may contain. So don't surf unreliable sites. Use social networking site with caution. That means we must limit information on social media sites. That means we should not keep all the data in social media sites. Follow netiquettes. That means rules. We must not use rude or bad language while using email or chatting or blogging or social networking. We should respect other views and we should not criticize anyone in the internet. That means we should not use our rude or bad language in the chatting. Next one is finding the people on internet. That means finding the people on internet means some of the search engine helps us to search for the people. We can search our old school friends, relatives, or people who are not in touch with us. We can find information about them provided that the person has filed in the internet. That means like Facebook is a good example, Twitter is a good example. You know how to search and how to find the people. If anybody student doesn't know how to find the people, they can contact me. I will show how to find the people on internet. There is here you can see some popular sites. According to the textbook, there is People Planners, Anyhoo, and People.com. So these are the places where we can find the people. Nowadays we are using Facebooks, Instagrams, and there we can, everybody knows how to find the people on internet. Next one is e-greetings. That means e-greeting is an electronic greeting card. It is similar to postcard or greeting card, with the primary difference is being that created using digital media instead of paper. By using instead of the paper, we are creating the digital platform. That means by using online, we are creating the greeting cards. E-greetings are made available by various internet sites. You can send it through email. It also considered more environment friendly compared to traditional paper card. Instead of using the papers on this one, we can use eco-friendly type of greeting cards. Some of the popular e-greeting card sites are ecards.com, bluemountain.com, and 123greeting.com. Steps to send an e-greeting. Open the website 123greetings.com. Type Teacher's Day in the search box and click on Go. Click on the desired e-card will be open in a new window. Click on Send this e-card now. Fill the receivers and sender details on the given boxes. Example, name and email IDs, and type your message on the message box. You can also choose delivery date by clicking on the calendar icon. You can select today or date up to 60 days only. Click on Send Now button and your e-card will be delivered to the recipient on the scheduled day. That means you can send the e-card, e-greetings by this above procedure. Now let us have a look on a small video how to send an e-greetings. First we will open this 123greetings.com and the website will be open here, and here you see search here. For example, I am writing here Happy TACHERS Teachers Day. Click on Go. See, these are called pop-ups. Don't click this kind of pop-ups. It may contain viruses. So I'm simply closing this one, and here I'm click this greeting card and play this one. See, this is a greeting card, and now how to send, customize and send this. Here you need to write the sender details. I am writing Tarun, and from my email address I am sending here, writing Happy Teacher's Day. I'm writing here and click on the receivers. I'm writing Deepak, and Deepak is the email address, and click on, and if you want to remember my, you can. Now when you want to send this one, today only you need to send. Added receiver name is added. So next one is, click on Send Now. See, it's loading and it's showing something. See, again the pop-up will come, I think so. See, don't click on this kind of pop-ups. Now see, thanks for sending e-card. We want delivery details. Your email e-card has been sent to successfully created. An email has been sent to Deepak with the e-card details. As a copy of e-card also shared with the instructions on how to track, delete and edit. We will send you a separate email when the e-card is viewed by the receiver. So in this way we can send the e-cards. Next one is Google Drive. Google Drive is a free cloud-based storage service that enables user can store the data or access file online and anywhere. This service synchronizes stored documents, photos and more across all your users' devices including mobile devices, tablets and PCs. That means it is a drive where we can store our data in the cloud-based storage. That means in Google Drives we can save the data, not only phone or not only system, we can save the data. Next one is uploading files and folders into the Google Drive. You can upload or view, share, edit files such as documents, images, audios and videos with the Google Drive. When you uploaded a file to the Google Drive, it will take some space in your drive. Even if you upload one to folder owned by someone else also, that means some space will take by the Google Drive. Step 1, on your computer go to drive.google.com, then open or create a folder. Then to upload files and drag them into the Google Drive, you can also copy and paste your files to the Google Drive. Organize your files in Google Drive. To organize your files in the Google Drive, you can create the folders to make it easier to find and share with the others. First, we'll open the drive.google.com. On the left, click new folder and enter the name of the folder name and click on the create. Next one is sharing folders in Google Drive. You can share the files and folders which you have stored in the Google Drive with anyone. When you want to share them from the Google Drive, you can control whether people can edit or comment only view of the file. Steps to share the files on the Google Drive. Go to the Google Drive on the computer and click on the file that you want to share. To specify whom you want to share with the under people category, the email address of the person and click on the send. Let us have a look on a small video on the Google Drive. Yeah, look at here. First we will open the drive.google.com. I opened this one and this is my drive. And next one is you want to add the files. There is a new here. Have you seen? Click on this one and click on the file upload. Which kind of file? I am uploading the Apple and laptop. Two files selected. Click on open. See, uploading the two items. See, green color tick mark is there. So that means it is uploaded. Two uploads completed. Now these files are now officially in internet. These files can be used or view or anywhere in the world where internet access is available. And next one, these two should be in the particular folder. Then how to create a folder here? Here it is a new is there. Or right click, you can write new folder and write the new folder name. I'm writing here for UITS fruits. You can create. Then fruits has been created. I'm going to create one more way in new and click on folder. I'm writing that computer. A laptop. Create. See, now what I will do, right click on this one or hold and drag and put it in fruits and hold and drag put it in the laptop. See, now if I open the fruits images will be there. If I open the laptop image will be there. And if you want to share this one file or folder, right click and click on the share plus. See, write the email address from there. I am sending this email address and message means any message. And what he can do, just he can only view and click on send option. See, person added and almost all this image has been sent. In this way we can use the Google Drives. Next topic is blog. Blog is an informational website published on the www that allows users to discuss and share their ideas and about with the world. It is derived from the word web blog. The person who writes a blog is known as blogger. Blogging can cover any topic. It is an interactive activity. Readers can comment and respond to the blogger's post. Next one is how to create a blog. First we will need to open the blogger.com. Sign in using your Gmail user and password. specify the title which will appear the top of the page of your blog. Also provide URL for your blog, which will identify your blogs on the site. Different themes will be displayed. Select the theme of the choice and click on the create blog button. Your blog has been created. Let us see how to add content to your blog. After creating your blog, posting page will be displayed. Enter the title of the post in the post text box. After text enter, click the publish button to publish your post. View blog button is used to view your own blog. Settings tab is used to edit your profile and blog address, and also invites others to view your blog. Layout tab is used to change the appearance of your blog. After making the necessary changes, sign out the top button used to log out of your blog. Differences between the blog and website. Website main content always remain the same. Regular updates of content, that means the main information will be always in the same in the website, but that updating the contents of the post will be we are updating in the blog. Displayed in prescription format, but the blog will be like informal display. Interactive does not exist. Interactive in nature, that means when website all the persons cannot interact with the website persons, but in the blog everyone can interact with you. Used to transactional purposes, used for educational purposes. Almost every business has website, only some have blogs. That means every business persons will be having the business websites, not persons, business companies. Only few are using the blogs. Now let us have a look at a small video regarding blogging. Yeah, open the Google and write here blogger.com, and here blogger.com is there, and open this one. Create your blog, and it will asking for the Gmail account. As we discussed, I am signing with the Gmail account. And here title of your name of your blog, I am writing here my writings. Next, what is the URL of your blog. Suppose I am writing here dot, you can write here Teja writings. This is also not there, we need to write Teja my writings. The blog is available. Now click on the next. What is your display name? Write your name or display name. I'm writing here Teja, and click on finish. See, my blog has been created successfully. Now there is no new post. I am going to create here new post and click here title about apple. In bracket I am going to write fruit, and I am opening Google here and about apple. And this link copied, this link is copied, and here we need to write welcome to my page. Okay, and click here for more info. I'll write here link. Where is that link option? Here, this. And about Apple, and paste or search for the link. I'm writing here and click on apply. Now click on publish, confirm. See, now view blog. See, tejamywritings.boxpro.com. see, my website, it is my writings, my website title, and click here to more information about Apple. If I click this one, see about Apple, is open. In this way you can create your own blogs, that means own website kind of thing. This is not a website, but this is called blogs, where you can express your feelings in this blogs. And last topic is podcast. Podcast is a combination of two words, iPod and broadcast. Podcast is a form of audio broadcasting over the internet. You can use your computer with some music software or phone to download the broadcast, which makes podcast is different from the searching and downloading music files. It is all about the having the files come through syndication instead of going to the files through search. Some podcast feed reading such software such as iTunes and configure it to the downloads and transfer the podcast directly to your portable player automatically. That means it is kind of example, it is not kind of do you know about the radio? Radio by the through the signals we are receiving, the audio will come. In the same way, podcast also same, where you can get the signals, only you can hear the audio. You cannot see. In the podcast we can hear the audio. In most probably we will see this podcast option in the iPhones. Now Spotify is there, where you can listen the audios. That is also called a podcast. Through the signals, it will receive the audio clips. Okay students, that's all for today's class. Meet you in next class. Till then, take care and stay safe.